Hello, I'm Francesca Furno with Siemens PLM Software. Today I'm going to introduce to you new advanced developments regarding aeration within liquids. LMS Imagine Lab hydraulic libraries has always taken into account air within liquids, either in dissolved or undissolved form, depending on the pressure level with respect to the saturation line. Anyway, today you have more options available in the fluid icon, and this option allows you to consider different effects. So, for example, variable air amounts as the inputs to your hydraulic system and components, but also dynamics for aeration and dissolution, which are represented by time constants. New aeration models are available in the fluid properties models. So clicking on the icon, you will access to the aeration group, and in particular, you have an enumeration corresponding to air and dissolution. You have several options. You have GANS transport and GANS transport and dynamics, where you can change, for example, your time constants. Today, in this video, we will select the GANS transport option, and we will consider an hydraulic valve train with a variable air as inputs to the valve train. And anyway, if you are interested into these topics, and in particular also to air release and dissolution dynamics, you can also watch the second video on the same topic. Today we are considering then an hydraulic valve train with a rocker arm configuration, and LMS Amesim animation tool allow you to represent the working principle of the system. And in particular, you can link simulation variables to 3D objects in order to visualize the motion of each element. In particular, you have a rotating camshaft, which is pushing a rocker arm in charge of transforming the rotary motion into a linear motion of a piston. And the piston is compressing and decompressing an hydraulic chamber, which is transferring the motion to the engine valves. The fluid compressibility in the collapsing chamber is very important regarding the dynamics of the system, and in particular the delay and lift of the engine valves. The lubrication circuit is supplying the hydraulic valve train and is represented as a source of constant pressure at 3.5 bar, a constant temperature for simplicity, but a variable air amount. This is due to the fact that during the working cycle of the vehicle, the lubrication circuit is more and more aerating, and then we want to consider an increase of aeration as a boundary condition for the hydraulic valve train. In order to consider variable amounts of air inside the hydraulic system, we need to select the GANS transport option within the fluid model. And consequently, we need to provide with a variable signal, a variable amount of air as input. In this example, we will apply to the system a variable total gas amount and an undissolved gas amount, which is corresponding to a volumetric percentage of air from about 0 up to 30%. During the simulation, the air will be transferred from the inlet up to the final linear actuator, which is finally the engine valve, and the air will reach the final collapsing chamber with a certain delay, and we can have a look at the void content into the collapsing chamber. This amount of air is increasing during the simulation. That means that the compressibility of the chamber is also increasing, and consequently we have a weak transfer of the motion from the camshaft to the engine valve. If we consider several engine cycles, we can use a specific Elements Amesim facility, which is the modulo plot, and with the modulo plot we keep a constant the camshaft speed, the supply pressure, but we provide a variable amount of air, and we can check the valve lift during several working cycles. And in particular we see that with an increasing amount of air, the engine valve lift is decreasing due to a higher compressibility in the collapsing chamber. In conclusion, new advanced aeration models allow users to consider variable air amounts as input to hydraulic system, and in particular allow to optimize the either the design or the control strategies also in the worst case conditions for the system behavior. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.